Thanks for watching this video tutorial on the Audison AF-Forza DSP amplifiers. The AF-Forza family of amplifiers are compact, powerful, great sounding, and have advanced bit processing for OEM correction and system tuning all built in. We've installed Bit Drive 3.0. Now what? Let's familiarize ourselves with the controls and tools and look at some settings we want to configure for regular use. Open the BitDrive software by double-clicking on the icon on your desktop. This window appears. The version number here should be 3.0 or higher. If it's lower than 3.0, you need to download 3.0 and install it. If an AF bit amplifier is connected on the USB, the model number of that amplifier will appear here. In the upper right, we can close the software by clicking on the X. That's useful if we've opened the software in error. Over here is the refresh icon. This will update the list of amplifiers connected to the PC. If we click on the tab Offline, we can choose a virtual instance of any AF bit amplifier model. That will let us see and manipulate almost all of that processor's functions without it being connected. For this overview, we want to see all the functions. So let's go back to that M5.11 bit and click on it. When the handshake between the software and the amplifier is over, the BitDrive software opens the main window. This displays all the functions that are available on the connected device. The system map on the left shows no speakers around the vehicle. That indicates this device has not been configured yet. We may see a notification in the upper right regarding available firmware updates. We can see that there is an AF bit device connected because we can see online here, we can see the model number here, and we can see the firmware version installed on that amplifier here. The BitDrive main window isn't maximized initially. We can maximize it by clicking here in the upper right corner. You may want to change the app scaling setting in Windows to change how the software looks on your laptop screen. Let's review the icons across the top of the screen. When the cursor hovers over an icon for a few moments, the name of that icon will appear. Open. The one on the far left is the open icon. We use that to find a configuration file that we can open and load. Only .cfg files can be loaded. Save. The next icon is the save icon. This saves the current configuration file to the PC. Assign a file name to the configuration file. Vehicle make, model, and customer name are commonly used. Finalize. The finalize icon writes the configuration file settings to the AF bit device's non-volatile memory. That means the settings are retained after a power cycle. This is the most important button on the entire home screen. If you don't finalize your settings, you can accidentally lose hours of work. Always finalize the device before closing the software. Otherwise, the next time the system is powered on, some safety functions that use the sound system might be disabled. Configuration report. The configuration report lets you review all of the configuration settings in list form, and you can save them if you like. Here's the configuration report. This can be saved to the PC for later reference. Triggers. The triggers icon lets you enable and define how the two 12-volt positive input trigger wires will affect the AF bit device. For more on these inputs, see the AF bit amplifier manual. Features. The features icon lets you access a few different operating features to configure. Here's a list. Number 1, turn on and turn off delay. This setting affects the remote output wire of the AF bit amplifier. With Audison companion amplifiers, these values can be left at the default settings. Some other amplifiers may need adjusted turn on or turn off times to prevent turn on or turn off pop. Number 2, default volatile data. If the amplifier should ever lose power or be disconnected from the battery, it will default to the default volatile data settings when power is restored. These settings will be applied every time the device power is disconnected or reconnected. Warning, make sure to properly configure these settings before finalizing the bit device to ensure proper operation after a temporary loss of power. Otherwise, audio output may be lost and some safety functions might not be audible. In addition, the vehicle user might not have sufficient volume or sufficient subwoofer level, or may have poor sound due to the incorrect memory preset being selected. The settings that you can choose from are device volume, the default is 0 dB, but you can go up to plus 6 dB. Source, the default is the master source. If you're only using an optical input, make sure you set this to optical. Memory, the default is memory 1. Subwoofer volume level, the default is 0 dB, which is full output. Volume for zones 1 and 2. Turn on enable. This sets all the above values every time the amplifier turns on. It's defaulted to off if someone needs the amplifier to be at a preset level every time. This is the way to get there. Number 3, auto chimes, or chime integration. For more on this, see the owner's manual. Number 4, auto input switch, optical priority. For more on this, see the owner's manual. Number 5, upmixer. The upmixer derives a center channel from two-channel stereo, allowing center speakers to be used to deliver stereo imaging to multiple listeners. This setting adjusts the center channel level. This is covered in another tutorial and in the training materials. Number 6, dynamic power management. In some installations with low air circulation, amplifiers may approach the limits of their thermal range. Dynamic power management will limit the internal operation of the amplifier just before the thermal limits are reached, prolonging audio operation. If a specific installation regularly encounters thermal operating limits, Audison offers optional cooling fan accessories and recommends their use. Number 7, DRC AC. If a DRC AC is connected to the AF bit amplifier, it can be configured here. If no DRC AC is connected, this window will be blank. Number 8, ADS Maestro AR. If a Maestro AR is connected to the AF bit amplifier, it can be configured here. If no Maestro AR is connected, this window will be blank. Wizards. This button allows you to select either the configuration wizard for initial setup of the amplifier or the Accordo wizard for acoustic tuning of a configured system. Each of these will be covered in their own tutorial. Acoustic RTA. This button activates the acoustic real-time analyzer. Please note that if no microphone is selected in audio settings, the acoustic RTA function is not available. We'll cover this in the tutorial on tuning. Audio monitor. This button uses the same graphical display as the acoustic RTA to display the electrical signal being sent to a specific channel. It can be very useful when troubleshooting a system. Update Center. Update Center makes maintaining bit drive and AF bit firmware easier than ever. We cover the use of Update Center in the previous tutorial. Audio Settings. This button allows the user to select the microphone that the acoustic RTA will use and to configure some of the analyzer settings. We'll cover this in the tutorial on tuning. Settings. This lets you access persistent settings and preferences. Here's a list of optional settings and their default states. You can choose the preferred language for the user interface. The default is English. You can choose to enable keyboard shortcuts. They are disabled by default. You can select the keyboard type. The default is QWERTY. You can select centimeters or inches as your preferred unit of measurement. The default is centimeters. If your market uses inches, select that now. You can select left-hand or right-hand drive for your region. Left-hand drive is selected by default, but if you are in a market that has right-hand drive vehicles, select that here now. You can enable automatic snapshots of all your settings as you go. You can disable automatic checking for software updates. That's enabled by default. And finally, you can reset the device to all the default settings. Important. If reset is selected, all settings go to the default values and all audio through the device is lost. That will disable any audible safety functions until the amp is reconfigured. Keyboard shortcuts. This button displays the shortcut reference chart if you enabled keyboard shortcuts. Help. This button opens
in addition to the main help icon.
There are also help icons located in each functional section of the software. This allows you to easily access help information for that specific topic. About. This displays the version number of bit drive that's installed. YouTube video tutorials. When video tutorials are available for bit drive 3.0, this button will open a browser window and display them. Source selection. Click on master or optical to select the source of the signal you would like to amplify and process. Click on the edit icon to relabel the sources if you like. Selecting the edit icon here allows renaming the sources. It also exposes the enable disable button, which can be used to lock the device into just the master source. If you edit this setting, make sure you edit default volatile data to match. The Zone 1, Zone 2 controls are for use in different audio environments, and the zones can be relabeled with the edit icon. There are 6 memory presets which can be used to save various configuration settings. Each memory setting may be renamed, and memory settings 2 through 5 can be disabled using the edit function. A given memory preset can be copied to as many other memory presets as desired. This is really useful when you're editing and comparing different tunes. To the right of the memory preset controls are the controls for the final tune global equalizer. We'll review using the final tune global EQ in the tuning tutorial. To view the input channel settings, select Input. Each input channel has a sensitivity drop-down menu. The first value is for using the RCA inputs, and the second value is for the speaker inputs. The maximum setting is 6 volts for the preamp inputs and 22 volts for the speaker level inputs. The minimum setting is 6/10 of a volt of preamp input and 2.2 volts of speaker level input. This setting is not available for optical sources. The value here can be set using the configuration wizard, or it can be set manually. Each input channel has a 2-color virtual LED. When that LED is green, we're getting input signal on that input channel and it's within the sensitivity range we've selected. If the virtual LED is red, we may be exceeding the input sensitivity that we've set. It's useful to test this with our balance and fader controls on the source unit to confirm that the input channels are all connected correctly. Note, If you're using the virtual LEDs to set levels, use the frequency sweep track. Using music or using pink noise is not an accurate way to set these levels. Here's a green LED indicating sufficient signal. And here's a red LED indicating possible overload. The mixer determines where each output channel gets its signal. Click here to view the mixer settings. The column on the left shows all the available input channels, and the row across the top shows all the available output channels. This shows the mixer before it's configured. After you use the configuration wizard, any unused inputs and any unused outputs will be deleted. Whenever the mixer displays zero in every field, the system won't play any sound. Well, that's Bit Drive 3.0 summed up for you. Thanks for watching.